freestyle wrestling from the Olympic Wrestling Pavilion. 149 and a half pounds. Ludwig Kung of Switzerland has a tough draw. He draws in the first round Arsen Fatsayev, who's here in the blue singlet. Fatsayev is a six-time world champion and Olympic champion. Also won the Goodwill Games. His only loss back in 1989 when Kenny Mundy of the United States beat him when he moved up to 163. Quite a force in international wrestling, Jeff.
Well, Wilson of Canada also owns a victory over Fatsayev. That is just a style clash. You look atop of all the championships, and you see the name Fatsayev sitting atop them all at the 149 and a half pound weight class.
I'm Russ Hellickson, along with 1984 Olympic champion Jeff Blatnick, bringing you the first day of Greco-Roman freestyle competition. We had 5 days of Greco-Roman. It's going to be hard to make the shift, Jeff.
Well,
freestyle wrestling, 5 days coming up. This is the first day, three weight classes.
In freestyle wrestling, it involves total use of the body. Catch as catch can. Greco only holds above the waist. Freestyle, you'll see the traditional leg shots. Everything from double legs, single legs, high crotch techniques, trips, ankle picks, lace legs, just to name a few of the techniques that are very prominent.
And right now, Fatsayev out to a 3-0 lead. Use that leg lace for a turn. 3-0, 3 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. Matches same length, 5 minutes. Same number of officials, three on every mat. Two of the three must agree. Right now, we have Bradbury of Canada as the referee in this match at 149 and a half pounds. And very quickly, Fatsayev scoots around behind for another one-point takedown.
You mentioned his loss to Kenny Mundy of the United States. Fatsayev moved up a weight class at that time. He was considered the best wrestler in the world, and he felt that he could move up a weight class and challenge 88 Olympic champion Kenny Mundy at 163 pounds in the 89 championships. And he lost in the finals to Kenny Mundy. He was just outhorsed.
Well, 1 point leg lace, lace leg.
That was hand-to-hand exposure.
Some people call it the leg lace, some call it the lace leg. So you'll hear both.
Another 2 points, and that is a tough hold. Lots of pressure on the knees, ankles, and fibula, the shin.
And quite extensively, and I'm sure we'll see a number of those come up as competition continues here in freestyle wrestling. And right now, Arsen Fatsayev, one of the great ones in international wrestling, a freestyle fanatic, I guess you could call him.
Big difference between Greco and freestyle, how much of the body you can attack. Greco, upper body, freestyle, all of the body. And the prominent offense is leg shots. You will see a little bit of upper body tactics, but a lot of it can be countered simply by hooking your opponent's leg, especially if you go to back arch, because then he can reach in between your legs and split them, and that destroys any type of throw you were attempting.
And a number of the USA wrestlers, Kenny Mundy likes to tie up, over-under position will throw. We'll
nice
also see Townsend
drop.
Saunders, who's starting action today, who will take a nice shoulder throw. So
yes,
the combination of
throw.
A leg attack and upper body can be a good tactic for freestyle wrestling.
Well, like boxing, you work the body to get to the head, or you punch a lot at the head, and then you can get to the body. Ooh, Fatsayev, nice double leg. You see him reach back, knock that hand off of him so he can turn the corner.
And Bradbury will call one. 1 point confirmed by the mat judge, Matt Chairman. He's now ahead 8-0.
Look at the leverage on that shoulder.
But
he gets away. He gets away. Well, I think Fatsayev was looking for more than points there. His opponent from Switzerland, Ludwig Kung, kind of had his ankle at a funny angle, and I don't think Fatsayev appreciated it. The referee made him let go, and Fatsayev came back with a real tough arm lever, as it's called in the United States. There's a three-point technique directly from the feet to the back. Will earn you 3 points, and then on the mat, any back exposure is worth 2 points. Takedowns and reversals are each worth 1 point, as is hand-to-hand exposure. And the difference between the two exposure points on the mat is hand-to-hand is your back is much more elevated off the mat, not as much danger of being pinned. As the two-point exposure, you collapse your opponent to the elbow, shoulder, or head, and there you are much closer to the mat and much more in danger of getting pinned. Thus, you earn that extra point.
Ludwig Kung of Switzerland, 26 years old. He was ninth in the world's last year, but being manhandled right now by Arsen Fatsayev of the unified team. 11-0, 59 seconds to go.
Well, it looks as though Fitsayev is cruising here. Oh, look at that front headlock and just
takes his elbow.
Fitsayev is trying to put his elbow back in.
His elbow has popped
out. Fitsayev tried to put his elbow back in. Oh, my God.
That spelled disaster for
What happens is he posted and you could see it just hyperflex and he just rolls over in agony. Oh, tough injury in wrestling. That happens.